Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Anisa Kapadia and I practice rheumatology in Bombay. This video will address the topic of fibromyalgia. Fibromyalgia is a recent condition which has gained importance worldwide. In India, I would still say it is under-recognized. So what is fibromyalgia? Let's break the word down. Fibro means fibrous or hardening and myalgia just means muscle pain. Again, as most many things, it is common in women. Women in their 20s, 30s, but almost at any age can experience this. Some estimates say it affects 3% of the population, which is actually a very large number. I won't call this a disease, it's more of a condition. There's no disease because although a lot of research has gone into it, no pathogenesis has been discovered to be foolproof. So what happens in this condition? Patients often experience chronic widespread pain, which they find difficult to localize. They also say that any kind of tenderness or any kind of pressure over their body causes excruciating pain. And although there is a lot of pain, unfortunately, most tests come up normal, in the sense that there is no objective evidence of inflammation. This is very frustrating for the patients because most people think that they are either making it up. However, now more and more we do know that this is a very real condition affecting a lot of people. Patients with fibromyalgia often experience poor sleep. This in fact creates a vicious cycle. The poor sleep is because they can't sleep because of the pain, and this again increases the pain as the insomnia worsens it. Fatigue is a prominent feature, also what we know as fibro fog, where they have impairment of memory and poor attention span. These features are very troublesome, but the treatment options are less. So the most important treatment remains aerobic exercises. Aerobic exercises may be a gym workout, it may be dance classes, Zumba, or even swimming, whatever suits you. And this should be done in a graded and a paced fashion. Initially, exercise may worsen your pain, but in the long run, it will help. Medications, although are there, they don't often work very well and they do have side effects. So exercise does remain the key. The other important thing is to know that we should rule out underlying conditions such as thyroid, vitamin deficiencies, and of course, rheumatic conditions. Rheumatic conditions are often known to present with fibromyalgia early on before exhibiting the typical features known with these conditions. It is important to see a doctor, if nothing, to rule out these conditions and also to gain reassurance. But most importantly, exercise remains the key.